Well, this week we continue our series on the seven passion killers. Seven things that can sneak into your life and snatch the passion right out of you. Now, so far, we've looked at the first two, an undernourished spirit and an unbalanced life. Today, we pick up with passion killer number three, an unused talent. An unused talent will cause you to lose your passion for life and your passion for God. 1 Peter 4:10 says, "Each of you has been blessed with one of God's many wonderful gifts to be used to make yourself wealthy, to increase your sense of self-pride, and to swell your ego beyond..." Oh, thank you. Oh, let me try it again. Each one of you have been blessed with one of God's many wonderful gifts. To be used in the service of others. So use your gifts well. So God gives you certain talents, abilities, personalities, gifts that help transform you into the men and women that He has created us to be. And those gifts, those talents that we've been given, they're not merely for our own personal benefit, they're also for the benefit of those around us. So my gifts, few though they be, the gifts that I have received from God are also for the benefit of those around me. And the gifts that God has given you are also for the gifts of those around you, for our mutual benefit. We are to use our gifts and talents to serve other people towards the good of all people. Now, this next statement that I'm going to make, it's an application, or it's a statement that no one here is disqualified from. Okay? All of you watching, joining us online, this applies to every single one of you as well. God has given you a special role in this world. God has given you a special role to play in this world. He wants you to use the unique way He has created you to make your unique footprint on this earth. God has created you with something uniquely spectacular to contribute to this world, to this community. God says, "I have given you these unique gifts, these unique talents, and I want you to use them. Don't hide them. Don't hold them back. Don't be shy about them. Use them." Now, at the risk of sounding cliche, use it or lose it. If you don't use your talents, you will lose your passion. God did not give us our special gifts, our talents and abilities, so we could hold them back or hide them or do nothing with them or use them solely to benefit self when others are suffering. God says, "I want you to use it or you're going to lose it." Now, to be more specific, to bring it a little closer to home, if you are stuck at a job in which none of your talents and abilities are being utilized to any significant degree, I can assure you, and I speak from experience, you will lose your zest, your zeal, your passion in life. It is going to burn you out. In fact, studies have shown that 70% of all Americans are in a job that does not utilize their true talents. 70%! How tragic is that? It's tragic, and it makes God sad. It makes God sad because God did not create you and give you those amazing talents and then say, "Now, I've given you these special talents, these specific set of skills, but don't use them. Just go out and make some hard, cold cash any way you can." That's not it. Now, this is where you may want to reach out and grab the chair in front of you and get a firm grip on it, because what I am about to say is a bit controversial. Are you ready? There are some things in this world of far greater importance than money. Shocking, I know. There are things in this life of far, far, far greater value than the mighty dollar. And one of those things is discovering the way God has uniquely made you, then learning to actively use the way God has uniquely made you to make your unique footprint on this world. And when you leave your unique footprint on this world, it echoes in eternity. God has created you with something uniquely spectacular inside of you. And He wants you to use what's inside of you to contribute and help those around you and outside of you. This is what we frequently call living out God's purpose for your life. Someone may be tempted to say, well, you know, I don't think God has a purpose for my life. I'm just kind of here. Well, with all due love, care, compassion, and respect, allow me to very gently say, you're wrong! You're wrong. God would not make you the way He made you if He did not have a very special plan and purpose for your life. And part of that plan, part of that purpose involves you discovering and actually using all that He has given you. And God is grieved. He is grieved when He looks down and He sees you in a job or living a life where you're not utilizing these talents. He's going, why? Why do you think I gave you all those unique things that make you you? Just so you can hold them back? Just so you can hide them? Just so you can be shy about them? No. If you do that, you will lose your passion. Now maybe this will help. If you're in a job right now, and that job uses only 30% of your talent, that will result in what I like to call a 70% boredom factor. Can anybody relate to that? You're bored with your job because it's not using the talents and abilities and creativity that God has hardwired into you. Some people are so bored with their job. Other people, every single morning, they get up with this sick, yuck feeling in their gut, and they just do not want to go to work. And yeah, part of that is because there are people who also have unique talents there, and some of their unique talents are being annoying and obnoxious. But another part of it is, when you're at work, there's no sense of you utilizing the true potential that God has given you. And as a result, we begin to lose our zest and our zeal and our passion for life. In 1 Corinthians 7, this is affirmed. Each one should live his life with the gifts that the Lord has given him. God gave you gifts and talents and abilities to use. And the reality is, you will never find a job that uses 100% of your abilities. You're never going to find a job that is 100% fulfilling. Do you know why? You were never intended. God did not create you to find 100% satisfaction through your job. Your job or your life is far more than your job. You are more than what you do. That's why we have this beautiful word that we call ministry. God wants you to have a ministry. That's why we need to be involved actively in our local congregation. We need to be involved in a ministry that provides an outlet for you to use those skills and talents and abilities that you don't get to use in your job. Because let's be honest, no job will ever be able to utilize 100% of the talents God has given you. So we need a job, yes, but we also need a ministry. A ministry that expresses what you're good at and who you really are. That's why we so frequently encourage people to get involved in ministry here. We encourage you to find a place to serve. In fact, that's part of the church's purpose and plan, is to help you find your click in life. We are called to help you find your click in life, that place where you just seem to fit in and everything seems to belong, you seem to belong and everything seems to make sense. Now, here's one of the biggest barriers to finding this fulfillment. And I'm guilty of this myself. I just am. It happens. Sometimes we make the mistake of believing that we have to be extraordinarily talented in extraordinary areas for God to use us in extraordinary ways. And we minimize the amazing things that God can do through us. And it's so not good. The truth is, God, as you read through the scriptures, you see over and over and over again, God using common people to accomplish extraordinary things. One of the greatest things that you can do in this life is to discover who you're not. Because once you discover who you're not, then you can discover and fall in love with who you are. With who God made you, how He made you. To help us get a little tighter hold on this, I'd like us to watch the following video. Let's watch this together.
Mr. Holland?
You're late. And you left your clarinet here the other day.
Yeah, if you know anyone who wants it, well, I'm giving up the clarinet. I'm just goofing everybody else up anyway. So, I just wanted to say thanks. Thanks for trying.
Is it any fun?
I wanted it to be.
You know what we've been doing wrong, Miss Lang? We've been playing the notes on the page.
Well, what else is there to play?
Well, there's a lot more to music than notes on a page. These guys, for example. Now, they can't sing. And they have absolutely no harmonic sense. And they're playing the same three chords over and over again. And I love it. Do you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Why?
I don't know.
Yeah, you do.
Because it's fun?
That's right. Because playing music is supposed to be fun. It's about heart. It's about feelings and moving people and something beautiful and being alive. And it's not about notes on a page. I could teach you notes on a page. I can't teach you that other stuff. Do me a favor. Pick up your clarinet and play with me.
Okay.
And this time, no music.
Oh, what?
Because you already know it. It's already in your head and your fingers and your heart. You just don't trust yourself to know that. Okay. Here we go. Ready? One, two, three, four. Okay, let's do it again. And this time, not so much lip on the mouthpiece.
Okay.
One, two, three, four.
Oh.
All right, no, 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 don't do that. Let me ask you a question.
What?
When you look in the mirror, what do you like best about yourself?
My hair.
Why?
My father always says that it reminds him of a sunset.
Play the sunset. Close your eyes. One, two, three, four. Don't stop playing.
Whit Hobbs wrote, "Success is waking up in the morning and bounding out of bed because there's something out there that you love to do, something that you believe in, that you're good at, something that's bigger than you are and you can hardly wait to get at it. It's something that you'd rather be doing than anything else, and you would never give it up for money because it means more to you than money ever could." Passion and purpose go together. Nothing matters more than knowing and living out God's plan and God's purpose for your life. Nothing else can compare to living there in that sweet spot of God's perfect plan for your life. Father, we thank you that even when we get distracted by the shiny things of earth, you have this magical way of drawing us back to you. Father, we pray that you would forgive us for moments when we've been distracted or we've allowed our values to get out of whack. We pray you would forgive us for times when we experience self-doubt. We have trouble believing that you could use us in any significant way. We thank you for reminding us, every single one of us, thank you for reminding us that we have value and importance in your eyes. And if we will simply surrender to you, you'll teach us how to play the sunset. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name.